Good evening to one and all present here. I, Neil Raka, Head of Events at RBC, welcome you to the most awaited series, COVID Pe Charcha, organized and presented by Russell of Book Club. In this series, we will be having our frontline workers, our heroes who fought on the front side of COVID to save us. Today, in our first episode of COVID Pe Charcha, we'll be talking about COVID variants, the reason behind the same, the evolution of human beings in the role of viruses, history of the virus with none other than Dr. Hiranappa Undur. Dr. Hiranappa Undur is a consultant pulmonologist at Inspire Speciality Clinic at Sarkar Nagar, Bangalore, since October 2015. Welcome to our organization, sir.
Thank you. Without wasting much of your time, we will try to stick to the points what was given by Rahul, Niharika, and Niranjan, and this thing. We will stick on to that point because वैसे तो चर्चा करते रहे तो चाय पे नहीं वो डिनर पे समाप्त होगा. Okay, so I feel we will restrict to that. So on this, why this virus has entered the human world, and what was the reasons for COVID? Why we get once in a decade these kind of COVID infections? We all know that exactly a decade when it was exactly a decade decade in 1918, the Spanish flu. It's a pandemic. There is something called as pandemic. We call it as pandemic because each and every country is being involved. Means each all continents across the continents are involved. There is something called as epidemic, like some cholera outbreak has happens. Many people will be affected by cholera and it will subside. So it will affect certain region. And endemic means it is always there in the community, like dengue is endemic. It is there always. Once in some times, if there will be a dengue seasons will be there. It will come down, will go. That is called as endemic. Pandemics are once in a 100-year phenomena. So this flu, when it came, I don't know what is the reason it comes in the human evolution. Normally, as human beings are the most formidant creatures in this world because they can think by brain, they can act, they can talk, and they can do many different things. So right from dinosaurs and these things, this time immemorial, we have virus, we have bacteria. We have tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is there. All kinds of infections are there. Why this this happens, we don't know. There are many people say that it is manufactured in China. It's a lab outwork and other things. There is a conspiracy behind that. All those thinking processes there. That will be different altogether. But it has come now. We are facing it and we have faced it and we are moving forward. So what exactly has happened is in this situation is, normally the flu, influenza, surveillance, whatever they used to do in 1918, they will take a form, it will be there in some form of, so we might have heard as swine flu and other things, it was there in a peak. Sometimes it becomes active, the virus nature is mutation. So for us also in our genes, lot of mutations will happen. So it will change. So that mutations are multiple, it will lead to cancers, or sometimes it will happen for a good, it happens for a better survival, it happens for better things also. These mutations, when they are dividing at a fast rate, it mutates more. So at some point of time, it can get assorted. So in the swine and human being, and when they get assorted and the virus becomes stronger, then the virus is really strong. And then when it's really starts spreading from one human to other, then it becomes really infectious to other. And we were seeing that viral, we used to get viral fever. A person who is infected in the home, a child is infected, then another child will get the flu, then their father, mother will get, then their grandfathers will get. This is called as flu, that viral fever and all. This COVID is something which is similar to that which happens to flu. Flu, it happened in that time also, all were wearing masks, that there was no information that time. We used to read newspaper, and international travel was not much. So it started with China. In this virus, when it Wuhan, it originated there. It in the meat market. They say that some virus has come out of that. It started spreading across the boundary, across this thing, and it has really caused havoc. So it is highly infectious. It spreads by coughing, sneezing. That's the major route. They say even on touching hands, it spreads, or like fomites. When you sneeze on the table, it falls. Then you take that, touch your this thing. It can stay for 8 hours. Then you inhale it. Then you get viral-like symptoms, sneezing, cold, upper headache, generalized body pain. Sometimes lung is the most common organ which gets involved. We get pneumonia, oxygen will fall, we go on a ventilator, sometimes we die. Normally, virus infections, 95% of the time, we normally don't die. So viral infections without any treatment, body and human body is created in such a way that it can protect itself. It has defense capacity. So because sometimes the immunity is not good, it is not able to strike the balance, the virus wins the battle and it will kill the this thing. So why it entered, we really don't know the reason. Maybe it has come to teach a lesson to human beings. Maybe it has come to have a balance in the world so that it is not shaken over population, to take the population under control. We don't know. But this is really puts a lot of strain, and our normal routine has been restricted. Maybe it is just a warning sign. Just don't disturb the ecosystem. You are humans, be like human. We are not gods. So there is something above, powerful than human beings. We call it as divine, God. Scientists call it as a extraterrestrial energy or whatever it is there. Something is controlling, and some things in the ecosystems might change and it might come. I wish we will be able to come out of this COVID as fast as we came back in 1918. COVID might remain in future in our community, like H1N1. Every year we might see few cases, but these mutations and whatever it is going on, this is causing too much of problem and too much of headache, and the way our life has been disrupted, and we are very unhappy about it. Personally also, it is very stressful in treating the patients, and it affects every walk of life. And this we have seen in two months. That's why after I have seen the patients with all PPE, seeing deaths very closely, and only 4% require severe illness, and there was a development of vaccine and all. A lot of vaccine, Covishield, Covaxin, everyone, Moderna, Pfizer, all these vaccinations are good enough. They are 50 to 60%. They might vary with 70 to 80% based on Sputnik, whatever it is there. Vaccination is good as far as I am concerned. Vaccines protects. Vaccine is a subdued form of infection where your immunity will be challenged and you are ready to fight the vaccine, real infection when it really comes. And we really didn't know this is the fastest time that a vaccine is being developed in the country, in the world, because of the need and the demand, and vaccines have been developed and 7 or 8 companies are there and vaccines are being there. So it different strain, when the virus acts smarter by changing its color and this thing's texture, whatever we call as proteins and the mutations, it tries to escape from us. So these vaccines, whole body vaccinations, are whenever we take that, it will be protected. And we Indians have developed a regular conventional vaccine, Covaxin, and that is also good enough. And Covishield also good enough. In Europe, they were said the pulmonary embolism, Moderna, Pfizer, and all other vaccines, Sputnik, Russian one is also there, and there are new vaccinations in the pipeline. Above 18 years, some are 12 to 18 years, even the Zydus one are coming in a pediatric age groups. Normally, this virus doesn't affect everyone. It can be self-limiting. It will go on its own. Sometimes we need antiviral hospitalization. They may require remdesivir and all those things, ICU, ventilator, NIV, all those things might be required. To prevent the severe illness, vaccine will not protect from COVID. If you don't get your guards down, don't use the mask, and all the hygiene precautions or the social distance is not there. In the heights of infected, when you are seeing in lots of patients, we may get infected. So, but even if you get infected, you will not get severe disease. That's the role of vaccine. And we have 2 vaccines which are taken. Now there is a big role of booster vaccines, especially in a immunocompromised more than 40 years, having diabetes, hypertension, all those things. Vaccine is good. And there are new strains which are coming up, whether this vaccine will protect those strains also or not. And every time alpha, beta, gamma, delta, there are different names for the same virus whenever they change the mutations. whenever a mutation is happening surface some site, the sometimes the virus can die down and disappear. So sometimes the virus can become more transmittable, more it can acquire more strength to transmit one by other. So that will be done by epidemiologists. Whenever they get a viral infections, when they do an epidemiologist, when they really get those things, so these infections, what exactly it will happen means, this Omicron is one of the type of mutations which was detected in South Africa. It started spreading. Nowadays, they say WHO is telling that this is highly infectious form. Highly infectious form means it can also spread like COVID, what we see 2 years back, but it may not cause severe illness like COVID, like unlikely to that, and it may die soon. We were thinking that third wave, it will hit a pediatric age group and all. It didn't come, and it is not affected the pediatric age group because the immune system of pediatric age groups are so high. And people who are immunocompromised, their immunity is good, they might affect as well. In terms of Omicron, in terms of treatment decision, we don't have much in terms of treatment to offer apart from the post-exposure prophylaxis like certain casiviritinib and all antibody cocktails are available. That can flush out, like Trump has taken that injections during that time. That is the type of injections we are looking at. And there are a lot of development, a lot of research and all is going on in this Omicron, where the mutations are particular. It can escape detection also. Sometimes yes, gene, it might miss the detection. The best method to detect is a genome sequencing. Not every centers will have viral cultures, are not advised. When you detect it as Omicron and it is again a stress and trauma to the family and all, it might still go without any treatment, only with isolation, sometimes requiring antiviral. And there is no specific therapy for Omicron as such. Whatever we treat for COVID itself is a good enough this thing. How can we resist it? How can we resist it means we really can't do anything. We have to trust our immunity. We have to trust our immunity that immune system can drive away the virus, whatever it might be there, because our immune system is very robust. And sometimes we intervene by giving the steroids and all, got your immunity died. Timing of starting the steroids are important. So when it replicates, we have to halt the replication. Sometimes body will be able to do it. Sometimes it requires assistance in terms of drugs. Sometimes whatever damage, it has to be reversed. Now other organs can be involved, the kidneys, brain, and other things also can be get involved in this thing. Some COVID for strain reason, they have a high chances of stroke and heart attack. We need to give blood thinners, steroids, and all these are treatment. Sometimes the side effect over treating can lead to a black fungus, mucormycosis, all those complications. So how can we resistant means we still have to maintain any viral infections and all. We need to have this physical distancing. We don't have much of this thing. Social distancing, if there is an alert and those things, but we should not be scared. There are some treatments which are good nowadays. So whenever you are meeting a stranger or anything, we need to wear the mask, and sometimes certain protocols have to be followed. And first thing is not to get infected. By chance you are getting infected, it's not your fault. You may get infected. It's not like we can't keep on blaming that you are not wearing the mask and all. Some people are very robust. Even if they are coughing, they just go. This thing, we have to be under protection. Even if that, there is another more protection level, which is there, a vaccine. Take vaccines, and there is a lot of troubled restrictions and vaccine attached to these things are there. 2 doses of action, whatever dose it is there, whatever company is there, it is good to take vaccination. Sometimes there are special that the people who don't take vaccines, we should not, it is their choice. It's a personal choice. Vaccine is definitely helpful. And some people have died after vaccination and this thing, these stories and all, we should not listen. As such, vaccine for everything, 1 in 1 lakh, 1 in 10,000, while the pediatric age group also, when we are taking it for kids also, they definitely come with some side effects. We should explain the risks and side effect and take a vaccinations properly. 2 doses, if boosters are recommended, first of all, we don't have that much vaccine pool. We need a recommendations from the government and the scientific bodies that the booster is recommended. And this is the booster we have to use. There's a lot of mix and match, which is going on European and all, whether we have taken Covishield earlier, now we can take Pfizer, Moderna, those things are going on. But booster and vaccine protection is not never lasting. It's not for life. Like polio and other things, whatever we have eradicated, the COVID might remain. But if you take vaccinations, it's always good. And there can be debate for not taking it and all. Many groups are also been there. I personally recommended vaccination is good. That's the best way to protect. Even if you are doing all those things properly, by chance you get a COVID positive, don't get be scared. If your immunity is there, do not panic and take your testing done and start the treatment early, antiviral, whatever is the best available at this point of time. There are new drugs which are molnupiravir and other drugs are been coming into a market, and that drugs are also effective. There are favipiravir, they say that this is not effective, that is not effective. There are some treatment which are available and we should be able to tackle it well. Okay, so I feel we should be able to handle with care, with lot of restrictions, lot of lockdown. It's not good for everyone. And this Omicron, how exactly it will unfold in future in next 2 or 3 months, whether it will be like a Delta virus, we really don't know. As of now, we can increase the guard. The nearer it comes, increase the guard. The far it goes, decrease the guard. So it is nearer in South Africa. We are seeing few cases. We are seeing few cases in Bangalore who have come this thing. Travel, there are recommendations are there. How to screen, where you are going. All those things becomes important. And don't panic. There are some treatment. Now hospitals are also geared up. Private hospitals are also geared up. There's appropriate isolation units and bed should not be a problem, but we should not get a situation where we got it in June or April, where the number of patients are so high, the beds are so less, everyone is asking oxygen. For the lack of care, they are dying. It's not because of lack of treatment, because we are not getting beds enough. That situation we should not be into. Hope government and all of them collectively, we should take a forward step and try to prevent ourselves from getting infected. Even if we are getting infected, proper advice, not making victimization of the patients and treating them. It is after all a viral infection. It can go on its own. By scaring through a media, through whatever channels of communications, and scaring a hell lot and making our life miserable for ourselves is not a good idea. We should always live our life fullest and don't be afraid. There are challenges in life. Even otherwise, without COVID, there are lots of challenges. And every day, many patients will die of accidents. We use helmets and we need road protection safeties. So we have to live with this COVID, and COVID will stay forever probably. But if there is some virus which becomes mutant, it's not only COVID. For everything, healthcare infrastructure has to improve, and we ourselves has to take more precautions and more protective in ourselves. In spite of that, if it you should get alarmed on the first sign of anything, this thing, there are a lot of conspiracy and other things there. Probably this pandemic will also not last forever. It has to come to them. Everything in life, good or bad, should end. I feel COVID will end, but it might remain as endemic, which is already been there. And we don't want a situation like pandemic treating all the patients. And by using all this social distancing, mask and other things, we can still be fine. Let's see how exactly we need to deal with these problems. I feel, Rahul, if you have any questions, we will be able to answer it. Probably that is the way we build on our presentation. Because everyone is hearing more about COVID. Every time I don't want to bombard with people with this COVID scare and COVID scare stuff and all. We should be protective, but we should come out of this COVID mentally and physically also. So it is so much strain, especially on healthcare workers, talking about COVID every day, day in and day out, and coming to the house, seeing in the newspaper the same COVID story, everywhere COVID. And sometimes the story is more and the disease is less. Sometimes the disease is more, story is less. So now at this point of time, I feel there are some COVID cases. It's okay, but it's not bad as it was there in the pandemic situations. We don't want to make it more worse. And government, administrative authority, they have learned the lessons. And even people have learned the lesson. People have lost their dear ones, near ones. They are more protective. And they are doing always more protective now, helping their own family members. And this has taught us all human race a lesson. And let's see how exactly we can live together with Mother Earth, nature, in synchrony, without disturbing the balance of Earth. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you to answer all the questions. It was actually a great session with you. Sir, I actually have a personal question from myself. Sir, can you please explain your experiences during COVID as a doctor, as a frontline worker?
Yeah, it was very tough initially because we didn't know the treatment. If I am getting affected, what should I do? What should I do with the family member? When I'm going back, my parents, how they can be protected? They are more than 65. And how about their kids? If they are protected, how exactly the BBMP will react? They might lock down your house. They may not allow you to get all the things. There's no nothing in even Amazon, whatever food you can order, that is very tough. So how exactly your earnings, means if you are not, your livelihood gets affected. All those things are going in mind initially. So initially we need to come out with this kind of challenges. Once you are a soldier, we don't, if you are a soldier and if the war comes, you can't sit at a home. And like a doctor, when there is something like that, we should put forward our face strongly, use all the protection devices. They wear PPE, they wear masks, they wear gloves, and maintaining the social distancing. Even with all these technologies, we have started using the phones and technology or video calling facility. We use different method to diagnose. We used to do more x-rays, more CTs, use preventive methods. And all of them who are treating the COVID should also be protected. There should be a definite area for entrance or exit. All those things was designed. It was really a tough one for us initially to do all this think of thinking and all. And there were a lot of restrictions from the government. Ultimately, the government hospital started treating, the private started treating. We used to see deaths more. We never used to get intubated. Then we devised the devices for intubation with all the protections. We used to intubate. We used to do all the things normally how we used to do with other conditions. And we never used to neglect the patients of COVID. We did the good job. People are doing well with the treatment. But since it is unpredictable, sometimes more than 75 years with comorbidities and all, it's literally like a death sentence. And things to improve worsen very fast. And it has taught us a lot of lessons in terms of dealing with the patients. They are emotionally connect. And since they were not seen physically, it was difficult to demonstrate for us. For us also, it was very tiring and very difficult because this is not the normal situations we worked in, but we have been through and we have done through. Now it is being easy now, and hope this doesn't last forever. And that was a horrible time of our life. And I feel at the end of the day, we are not affected by COVID. Then vaccine came and vaccine started protecting us. And everyone is not scared and everyone is treating COVID now. And sometimes there is over treatment, under treatment. Now we are getting it right. The new medications, the old medications, the better medications with better evidences are available. Now it is better. We don't want this Omicron to spoil the broth and become a big pandemic now. And I hope with this kind of awareness, and probably it may die down soon. And let's see how exactly we will proceed. And this was really a challenging time of our lifetime.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your time. Thank you for enlightening our brains with your speech, with our conversation. Thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you.
Thank
Any
you.
Questions? Rahul?
Rahul, sir, do you have any questions? Actually, I think we are not audible to him.
Okay. You are done with it?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you then.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for taking your precious time for us. It was a marvelous speech. It was a marvelous conversation with you. You have cleared all doubts, all introductory doubts that we had planned in our introductory session of COVID-19.